Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophonet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. We're ready to go on Operation Morbid Rhyme, where we need to protect another device, because we're on another guerrilla operation. So without further ado, this is the team and here we go. So yeah, we're getting closer and closer to furthering the story, because I want to do that as fast as I can. Is it really necessary that we start moving forward with that? But first, Operation Morbid Rhyme.
A resistance operative managed to rig up some sort of data interception device through an access point on the Advent network running through here. The data is apparently critical to the aliens' latest operation, and they're already moving to destroy the device. We're heading in to make sure that doesn't happen. Take out any hostile targets nearby, secure the AO, and protect that device.
So the same kind of guerrilla operation we had a few episodes ago. So protect a device, which means that we're gonna have to move in on the device as fast as we can. Dropping down out of the Sky Ranger, and there we go. That's pretty far.
We need to lock down the area and secure the device at all costs.
I saw something when the camera moved over. I think there's a turret right about here, but I guess I'll see you guys when I see something. And yeah, I think that was what I thought. Ooh. So it's supposed to be only 9 enemies, so if I'm not mistaken, that means those count as 4, although it might be that the turret does not count. I'm gonna have to be careful about that. So let's move a bit closer and set everything up, and I'll get back to you when I'm ready to fire. And things got even worse, because there's a second turret in the back there. What the hell is going on here? That is some heavy resistance for something that... They set up turrets next to a device that they want to attack. That is some very heavy resistance. But I'm going to move a bit further once more, and then I'll get back to you once I'm ready to fire. So that makes a very nice cluster. So now we're gonna get, yeah, okay, so they're outside. Wow, 11 damage. Ooh, I'm gonna have to hurry. Okay, Yang, I think it's high time you start with an acid bomb right on top of this general area. Maybe take out the car as well, because I really don't like that car. There we go. 4 enemies nicely clustered up and blown to shit. Goodbye. So the armor shredded of the machine gun turret and the mech.
We're in their sights.
And they took quite a bit of damage as well. Now they're gonna have to run through that acid cloud to get to us. Well, most of them are anyway. And the turret is of course awake as well. And the turret close by is 2. Okay, so that means I do want to take care of the armor of that first turret here as well. So Ulrich, can you fire at this super heavy turret with your super heavy gun? Goodbye. Armor shredded, and that... Well, sets him up nicely for what comes next. Because, of course, we're going to start using some pistol shots. I can't see the guys in the back, so I'm going to have to move a bit closer if I want to do everything I want to do. So, Vinny, get over here.
No problem, boss.
Oh, shit, Overwatch. I'm stupid.
Incoming fire!
Luckily, they missed. Holy shit, I keep doing that, don't I? Lightning reflexes. Who needs the biggest damage? Ooh. Well, you need some damage in. So, lightning reflexes on the mech. Good. By 10 damage, a whopping 10 damage. And hack defense decreased. But I don't really want that now. So face off. Let's kill pretty much everything inside, because we're gonna fire at 5 enemies. Here we go. And 1 kill. Oh, that was a miss. That's too bad. Oh, that was another kill. That was damage. And that was another kill, so that was 3 kills in one attack. That was freaking amazing. Thank you, Vinny. So with that done, now I might actually, because we still have a mech and 2... What is that? Oh no, just a shield bear who's gonna die immediately. And then the mech who's in trouble. So heavy mech, let's fire at him. Goodbye, governor. And then I don't need to spend any resources on that lancer because he's gonna die from the... Well, you know what he's gonna die of. From the acid burn, of course. So it's just Jazz and Cedric now. So I'm gonna put them on Overwatch. Yeah, thank you. Can I? Okay, that was weird. And goodbye. Because they're pretty close to us. They're right next to the building, if I'm not mistaken, because we saw one of them fire. And I think they're just gonna... Oh, there we go. So that's a sectapult. So that's why this takes... Ooh. Okay, I really gotta move. So. Don't run through acid, Jazz. Maybe just reconceal. If I reconceal and put you over here... Oh no, of course, I'm such an idiot. That pole is just gonna alert us again, of course. Gonna start moving around the acid cloud I created, because that's a bit annoying, of course. But not that big of a problem. We know they're in the building, because we can actually... Oh, it's a... That's an Andromedon. Not the sectopod. I was mistaken. I apologize. So that's something we can actually deal with, if I'm not mistaken. But we can get another hidden on the device, so I am going to take advantage of that fact. Maybe even check whether there's something in the security pole over here. Let's first check what's on the pole. Let's hack that thingy. Bypassing security. Bypassing. Not really bypassing, but here we go. System override. Reduce enemy will by 50% or squad recovers all action points already spent this turn. I really like that one. I really, really like that one. But we're gonna wait until next episode. Not next episode. Next turn to do that. Not next episode. God damn it. So yeah, give me a second to set this all up. Oh, and they're coming out of their own. With a bit of a frame rate hiccup. And a shotgun from afar misses, because that's our only Overwatch shot, because I wanted to set up something else, of course. But that is... Yeah, that is something. Not that big of a deal, I think. Because we can easily take out the 2 Vipers. What is that? There is a sectopod. Oh, shitballs. So here's what's gonna happen. I'm gonna try and take out everybody in this turn and try to get sight of the sectopod over there. If I can do that, I'm gonna try to recover all my... that is gonna be annoying. There we go. Goodbye, Viper. I'm gonna try and recover all my action points so I can do something about that sectopod. Because if we don't draw the attention, I think he might be able to kill that thing in one hit. That might have been a mistake on my part. How much does that thing have left? I think it can take one more hit. But that is risky. That is extremely risky. God damn it, then I do need sight on that thing to actually fire on it, of course. How are we gonna do this? Because that thing is behind the building. But in a position that he can still see the device. So... I'm gonna have to start firing at... Whatever I can get to destroy this building. To maybe open up a sight line to whatever's behind the building. So yeah, rocket to start this off. Shredding his building a bit. Do I get sight of the sectopod? It doesn't look like I did. Whew. Ulrich, get a bit closer.
Positive.
And I want you to completely demolish that building in the back there. How far can he even... Oh, shit. Okay, I'm gonna have to rely on Emma to get our actions back, because this is starting to get really, really annoying. Cedric, I do want to take care of that armor first. So Ulrich, fire away with a grenade and take out, well, most of the rest of this building. So I might actually see something over there. I'm not getting my hopes up, but I do need to clear out that sideline, because I'm actually not certain that the device would survive another hit. Nobody? No? God damn it. Cedric. I'm gonna try your lightning hands shot first. Although... Jesus Christ, this is something. So we have two snipers left and... Ooh, Emma. Could do a lightning hands on the Viper. Just to do so. And of course he misses. Not that big of a deal.
Shot field to connect.
And then we have another sniper shot on the Andromedon. Oh, and that took it out? I think that took it out.
You know that was good.
Yeah, okay. So that means we might actually be able to kill the Andromedon from here. Although we might not be able to. Yeah, I can't. God damn it. Emma, no. I'm gonna have to fire anyway. So let's fire at the Andromedon shell and try to take it down. Hopefully. So that was a normal shot. Just didn't kill it. Hack defense decreased though. So 5 health left. And now Emma. Everything rests on your shoulders. Hack that pole and give us our action points back. It's a pretty low chance. But if this doesn't work, we're gonna be totally screwed. So 69. It's the number of love, but please. Oh, thank God. Okay. We got this. We got this. We totally got this.
I'm in.
Okay, so that means we're gonna have to do everything in our power to get sight on that sectopod, which means getting somebody really, really close to it, which is not always a good idea. But this seems to be full cover, but I lose, of course, an action. So I'm gonna go over here, open the door, and see what else I can see here. So open the door.
Là, l'objectif.
That's the objective? Okay, but can you see the sectopod?
Move to protect that gear at all costs.
Oh, please. Oh, there. What? Oh, that is a bit of a bigger problem. So, I can confirm that the... how should I put this? The turrets do not count as enemies. I thought there was going to be just one sectopod, but of course we knew beforehand that there was going to be a gatekeeper. So I'm just making things up as I go, apparently. So the Andromedon is almost dead.
Sure thing.
But now we have a bigger problem. Literally, a bigger problem. I could actually hack it. That might not be such a bad idea. Emma, can you haywire protocol the Andromedon shell? Let's try and take control of that thing, because its hack defense has been decreased by the EMP shield. And it's pretty weakened already. So if I can take 50%, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna have to try this, because yeah, okay, thank you very much. Wow, that was over 90%. I don't think I get control of it immediately, but it's gonna help us out. We still have the Mimic Beacon, which we're gonna use to draw a lot of the fire. So thank you, Andromedon. And then, well, thank you, Emma, of course. Anybody else? We could fire at the Viper. But I think it's high time we get everybody a bit closer. The acid bomb is, of course, going to the gatekeeper over here. And I do need to be careful that I don't hit... This seems like it hits. It It's really hard to see because the orange kind of fades away with the orange of the fire over there, but yeah, I think that's gonna have to do. Because that thing has a buttload of armor. But this time we brought our acid bolts. There we go. Acid burn, 4 armor shredded, and 2 armor left. Everybody who comes through that is gonna suffer from the same effect, which might bring me to use the... No. What the hell? No, down. Yeah, there. That's full cover, right? Looks like it's full cover and everybody should see that. So, Mimic Beacon over there next to the wall. And then we could try and fire at... Can't I see the... Ooh, the Gatekeeper is in there pretty good. So, do I want to move Vinny up? I might actually. I am going to put down... Do you have an autoloader? Advanced autoloader. Okay, so let's reload Cedric. He really needs an expanded magazine, by the way. And then let's try kill zone on this area. So anything that moves in this area is gonna get shot at. There we go. And then we have the... Ooh, I can attack. I am gonna put him right in there. Because why not? I can only punch with the Andromedon. But it's something at least. I am gonna put him over there. Leaving a trail of acid as he goes. And he's immune to anything else. And now... I don't think I need to do anything else, right? Maybe I put him right in front of his face, but I don't think that's necessary. Let's try something else, though. So this won't count as his first action, so I might as well put him a bit closer and try and fire at something in... You know what? That Viper still needs to die as well, by the way. So let's get a bit closer with Ulrich. Trying to fire at that Viper over here. 77 on the Andromedon shell, 35 on the Gatekeeper, and 75 on the Viper. Oh, that was just a stalk damage. Okay.
Kein Treffer.
Which probably means I'm gonna have to take that thing out with Vinny. Yeah. That was a bit of a miscalculation on my part. Because Vinny isn't really good at firing his sniper rifle. He is really good at firing his pistol. But anything else might as well not bother. But we're gonna have to try this out anyway. So 69 on the Viper. If it hits, he's dead. If it doesn't hit, we're gonna have a problem. Okay, thank you very much. That was good. Okay, let's see how things pan out from here. I do actually want to just walk over to this side, so I leave a kind of an acid trail behind me and take care of the... if anybody walks through that, they're gonna get acid burn anyway. So that's 5 damage from the acid burn. And what else is gonna happen? So that thing is flying straight through it into the kill zone. So thank you, Cedric. Fire away. That was a miss because the Gatekeeper has an immense amount of defense, causing him to pass through most shots. He's gonna fire away at the Mimic Beacon. 11 damage. Jesus Christ, that thing hits hard. And then this thing is gonna get into the kill zone as well. The Lancer in the crosshairs might be a better shot. Ah, damn it. Come on, Cedric. Your shots are amazing. Why do you keep missing? He's gonna stab the Mimic Beacon. Yeah, and that destroys it, of course. So the Trooper is gonna have a free shot here. Okay. And he's gonna fire at... No! Okay, yeah, right. Because Cedric uses his Overwatch shots on actions as well. Oh, missed. The Trooper's gonna fire at the fucking device. Fuck you. Really? I don't really know why the Lancer didn't get damaged. He might be immune to the acid of the of the Andromedon. Let's see. So Ulrich is in a prime position to fire twice at the gatekeeper over here. His shots are terrible for some reason. But a plasma grenade might actually not be that bad. Because the Lancer is over there as well. If I can take out the Lancers... Yes, that's going to be the best idea I have, I think. Because this is only one action because of his salvo ability. This dude does guaranteed damage on the gatekeeper and removes its armor immediately. So that's good. That's really, really good. Now, we have another shot if we want to. He has a lot of damage in his arsenal, so I might as well try and take out... Well, take some damage on the gatekeeper. One damage guaranteed because of the stock, but nothing else. This is gonna suck. Yeah, focus. Please focus. 91. How much of these guys are still alive? Okay, yeah. Might as well first try the Andromedon here. And try and punch out the... Trooper over here. I'm gonna put myself on this side of him. Hopefully that doesn't damage the device, because melee strike 50%. That's it. Punch. Goodbye. So that was a trooper down. 10 damage. That's actually pretty nice. And then I could skulljack the Lancer. Not that it's necessary, but it's something we could do. But I think the chances will only be 70% here. So I might as well just try and fire at the gatekeeper here. I'm going to try and get a bit closer. Because she can't do anything else with her. Although... What? Because he's not... Is he a mechanical unit? I don't feel like he is. I don't feel like he is. So let's... Because they're only weak to EMP rounds and nothing else. Which is sad, but can't really do anything else about that. I have Jazz to kill the Lancer. So might as well take everybody and use them to kill the gatekeeper. Or try to kill the what? Oh, that was confusing. That was confusing. Never mind. Well, the Lancer is down. Yang, just fire at the gatekeeper, I think. Because you have been really good with hitting low percentage shots, but that's, yeah, probably not low enough for you. God damn it, that thing has such a high defense. So I think I only have, oh yeah, two snipers and a shotgun, if I want to. How are the melee chances actually? Ooh, 68. That is terrible. And 61 for the normal shotgun. What happens if I put you right in front of him? I don't want to do that. But I think I might have to do that. What the hell? How would I be able to stand on top of this? That is ridiculous. Can't run inside of the acid, because that's just bad. So I kind of made it hard on myself here. But I could try and hide behind this. But I don't think it's really of any use, because that thing can fly around whatever it wants, wherever it wants. So let's just try 66. Ooh, and even a... Ooh, that was nice. Is that it? A critical. Thank you, Jazz. That should have gotten you a promotion.
All hostiles are down and the area is secure.
That should have gotten you a promotion. Wait, who got wounded? Did anyone get shot at? What? Oh, I totally missed. What happened? What? Who got shot? Yeah, I can't really... Most under fire, the mimic beacon, so... Who got shot? Vinny dealt most damage, Ulrich made most attacks, and Jazz moved the furthest. And we actually have a new record on average enemies killed per turn, because that first turn was... An amazing one. Well, second turn, but the first killing turn was really, really cool, because we killed 5 enemies in one turn there and 3 in one fell swoop, because that's the power of face off with EMP rounds because they're just so powerful.
Well done,
look at the guys. It doesn't
really
look
good for morale when we ace a mission like that.
Guys, nobody got wounded. Nobody got a promotion as well. When is are they gonna get promotions again? Is that just halted or what? Or is that a dark event? We got one Illyrium core and a few other things. And there's the gatekeeper. Our initial readings of the old spherical creature we encountered show it to be of immense psionic power, potentially rivaling that of the elders themselves. It may be possible to reverse engineer its biomechanical components for use in our own equipment.
Considering the limited resources available to you, Commander, you have still managed to exceed my expectations. Excellent work.
Thank you, Councilman. Thank you very much. So, Dr. Callan Keenan.
I don't like the fact that we're chasing another set of coordinates into the middle of nowhere. We've done it before, and we didn't like what we found then either. Wilderness or not, the aliens could be setting up an ambush, or worse for all we know. Our people will be prepped and ready for a fight. I just wish we had more to go on.
Yes, indeed, Bradford. You and me both. I'm actually going to check this. So we have idle staff, because, well, they're not doing anything, but that's not too bad. But, yeah. I don't know why we're not getting promotions anymore. But let's check the Proving Grounds. I want to add another project here. Now that we have another Illyrium core. I am doubting what we should do, but I think it's high time we start looking for an experimental powered weapon. Because there might be something interesting in here. Blaster Launcher. This AI-assisted high-explosive shell launcher can guide its explosive projectile around obstacles to ensure maximum target impact. One blaster launcher has been added to the inventory. We apparently have one more Illyrium core. So I think we can actually build another warsuit with that. Because we have most of the ammo types and grenade types. So I actually want to make another warsuit with that. Thank you,
Commander. Ooh, how many? As soon as the project is ready for deployment.
We still have three more cores. Where the hell are those cores coming from? There's one more experimental ammo type I want. And there we have it. No, not Venom rounds. Well, they're handy, but not what I was looking for. I'm just going to wait with anything else, because let's just head to engineering.
Hey, Commander.
No, not engineering. The armory.
It's been slow going, but I've made headway interfacing our equipment with the alien technology still embedded throughout the ship. Most of the primary systems are now operating on some combination of our technology and theirs. My hope is to use the best of both worlds to come up with something new, something the aliens won't expect.
So let's swap out the normal rocket launcher, 4 to 7 damage, a range of 27 and a radius of 4, with a blaster launcher, damage 7 to 10. Look at that damage, 7 to 10. A 45 range, that's almost double the range of the normal rocket launcher. And a half, well, 50% extra radius as well. So the blaster launcher is a high-tech rocket launcher whose projectiles can navigate around blocking terrain. With the right squad composition and tactics, it can be used to devastate groups of enemies from extreme range. Because yeah, the range is incredible on this thing. I never actually built one of those heavy weapons. But those are amazing. You know what? Now that I see this, I might want to build another set of armor. So another armor vest alongside everything else. Do we have another PCS for Yang? No. So let's get back to the Proving Ground. So back to engineering and then the Proving Ground project.
Commander?
And let's add something else to the experimental armor. Let's add one of those as well.
I'll send word when the project is complete.
Because there's a lot of powerful stuff in there as well. But first, let's head to the bridge. I'm not really sure what we were doing there, but I think you were making contact with that area with South Africa, if I'm not mistaken. South Africa, yes, we were. But now that we're on top of the map, I might actually just fly to the black market first.
Avenger plotting new course.
And see what we can get for our intel there. Because we got the perks the perk that everything is 30% cheaper now. So let's check this out. Illyrium crystals, don't really need that. Superior scope would be amazing. Superior speed is good as well. I might just go for the flat out supplies here. 27, yeah, I'm gonna just buy that. And 13 intel for a superior scope. Duct tape not included. Hair triggers are the ones that give you free actions once every while, but superior scope. Yeah, I think that's something I want to buy as well, so thank you. And then we're gonna sell some stuffs. So they're very interested in alien alloys, so I think I'm my... Whoa. Easy there, cowboy. Let's sell them. Still, we have 130 left. Advent turret wreck. Why do we only have 3 of those? Do we get anything interesting? We still have 10 mech wrecks. So might reduce that to that. Give them another Viper corpse. Just trying to put everything to 15 around. That and everything else is fine, I think. Yeah, thank you very much. So just sell that. Thank you very much. And we have plenty of supplies left now. But let's head back to South Africa and start making contact. I know I'm ignoring a lot of the rumors lately, but we really need to boost our way up to those important missions. Because otherwise we're going to be just stagnating all the while. And yeah, we need to move this story forward now, don't we?
I have made a number of interesting discoveries.
And this is also a very, very nice one. So sector pod breakdown completed.
Central,
so let's check that out.
One of these things up close back in the day. Despite a lot of speculation, there was no pilot to be found once we pried it open.
So sector pods are not piloted. That's something we kind of knew already. When we first brought this thing in, some of the troops were still adamant that once we opened it up, we'd find a sectoid or worse at the helm. Fortunately, our precautions were necessary. There's nothing organic inside, no operator providing physical directions. Unless they're triggering it remotely, all indications point to this sectopod being an entirely autonomous weapon, operating according to the parameters of its system programming. This is exactly the sort of weapon that would have raised eyebrows in the past. I know Dad would have been apprehensive about arming a robot and sending it on its way. It's pretty clear at this point the aliens aren't bound by any moral or ethical obligations. If it's efficient and destructive, they seem to have no problem setting it loose on us. Thank you, Shen. So, this unlocks one of the best items in the game, so the Gremlin Mark III. The Mark III Gremlin is the most advanced version of the Gremlin drone, significantly increasing the hacking stat of all specialists. The specialist's abilities are also substantially improved when he or she is accompanied by his support robot. So this support robot. And we can completely, instantly break down the Advent turret. So let's do that immediately.
The turrets we see employed by Advent throughout their various facilities and security checkpoints are automated, much in the same way the alien mechanized units are. A significant amount of time was likely spent developing the optical sensors and targeting system, which I expect Shin will want to thoroughly examine following the disassembly process.
So there we go, hinting at what could benefit us.
Advent doesn't seem to have any issues stationing completely autonomous weapons in close proximity to the people in those cities. Really shows you how much they care.
So yeah, really shows how much they care. So new facility available, the Defense Matrix. That's something of an interesting room. I'm going to show you that in a minute. But first, we've run across the Advent turrets in a variety of places, mainly near the security checkpoints and other areas they're trying to lock down. Now that we've finally gotten a chance to pull one apart, I can say with certainty that the turrets are operating entirely on their own, with no outside controller or remote direction given. As much as I'd like to test the targeting sensors, Central and Dr. Tigan have both expressed their concerns about test firing the system before we know how it discerns between friendly and hostile targets. Considering how close the aliens position these things to civilians' occupied areas, the target recognition software must be incredibly accurate or incredibly basic. I wouldn't be all that surprised if the aliens were just flipping the switch and setting these loose on anyone caught in the firing radius. I'll have to see about setting up some sort of test environment. defense matrix. The defense matrix repurposes recovered Advent turrets as automated defenses to be deployed in the case of a ground assault on the Avenger. So we can add turrets to the Avenger, which is interesting to say the least. And I do want to have one of those in our, well, on our ship. But first, I think I want to do just a few interesting ones. But Chrysalids or Andromedon? I think I'm going to go for Andromedon first.
It does, in fact, appear that this creature is restricted to the confines of its own hulking environmental suit. Unfortunately for our troops, the suit itself is a powerful physical threat, regardless of the operator's status, as we learned with some astonishment in the field.
So yeah, we kind of know that by now, that Andromedon's come back to life. So in 5 days, that autopsy should be completed. But now, let's go
Advent
back.
Advent has made steady progress in convincing the remaining civilian populace to migrate to their city centers, with the propaganda campaign providing a constant stream of reminders as to the benefits of migration. They have maintained a steady influx of new converts. Unfortunately, most of these unwitting refugees have little idea what they are truly signing up for.
Yes, indeed. Because they're turning them into horrible monstrosities. But let's put an engineer into this slot so she can start building the defense matrix, which will be complete in 7 days. So, completing that, we're going to just head back to the bridge and finish scanning South Africa, because that will complete our area sweep of Africa. So we're going to have resistance bases on every bit of the African continent, and we still need to build one radio relay. So I think I'm going to just go ahead and do the...
We've established contact with the local resistance forces in this region, Commander. We're ready to move on the coordinates we pulled from the Codex.
Although, I do want to make... I do want to build another relay first. Because the bonus we get from Africa is that all the tactic costs are reduced by 50%. Which means that we can probably buy most of the upgrades in the Guerrilla Tactics School when we do that. So let's... Plus 105. So yeah, I'm going to install that radio relay over there. Because we're just going to do the Codex coordinates mission once we have that radio relay. Or before that, if the Avatar project starts freaking out before that. War suit completed. Thank you very much. I'm going to give that to Ulrich in a minute. Because he's going to be very happy with that. So 105 supplies added, and future combat has been added to the perks we have as well. So two more continents we need to start opening up, or maybe three. I'm actually mistaken. We need to make contact with three more continents, because of course Australia over here, we need to do that as well. But let's go out first and go to the Guerrilla Tactics School and try and buy everything there is, because new combat tactics. PCS bonuses are significantly improved. That is a really, really good one. And stay with me, of course, as well. And then we have the specialized perks for each character class. We have a bit of supplies left, but I do want to keep... Although I think we're pretty close to a supply drop as well, so I don't think that's so that much of an issue. So I'm going to go with integrated warfare. I'm going to show you the effects of that in a second. I do want to get Stay With Me, just so that soldiers will be more likely to bleed out than to die outright, just as a safeguard. Although these ones are good as well, but I think I can take two of those as well. So let's just go with Stay With Me, and then I can take two of the specialized perks. So explosives can inflict critical damage, which is just amazing. And then the specialist gain plus 10 aim and the ability to critical hit when taking overwatch and reaction shots. That's not really a nice upgrade for the specialist in my mind, so I think I'm going to go for Hunter's Instinct. So attacks against flanked enemies deal 3 extra damage, and sword attacks have bonus 15% chance to critically hit enemies, which is amazing for rangers, by the way. So I'm going to buy that, and then... critical damage for grenadiers on explosives. I think I'm going to go for that one, because that shot is good as well, especially with the pistol shots. But yeah, that's just depletes our supply. But I think, yeah, in one day we get a supply drop, so that's not that bad. But right now, even without that supply drop, I'm gonna go for something else first, because Codex Brain Coordinates, we've been holding this off for quite a while, but it's high time we start assaulting that area. So, Codex Brain Coordinates. 15 enemies, but they're really, really focused with their enemies. Andromedon, Elite Lancer, Elite Trooper, Archon, and Chrysalids. And I do want to focus on Chrysalids, because there's a buttload of Chrysalids in this mission. This is why this mission is so hard. There's 15 enemies, and I think at least six of them are Chrysalids. Might actually be more than that. Might actually be 8 or 9 of them are Chrysalids. And the rest are just, well, they're actually manageable. So Andromedon, Elite Lancer, Elite Trooper, and Archon. So most of them are organic enemies. So yeah, that's where we're gonna head right now. I do think the icon is a bit confusing, because they don't know where we're heading to, but that icon indicates exactly what we're gonna find there, because I did this mission once already. But yeah, I think we were doing pretty good with this team. I do want to make some changes, because of course, because we don't have that many electronic enemies, I do want to make sure that we kill anything else that comes too close, which means a lot of Overwatch shots. And I think it's really, really annoying, because EMP rounds would be handy just for the Andromedon, but since it's the only enemy with that, well, that is mechanical, I think I'm gonna remove Vinny and replace him with Benito. Although that might be a bit of a no. I'm just gonna take his stuff. And then maybe we're gonna need another specialist though, just as a healer, because I'm really afraid that we're gonna lose. Yeah, I think that's better. I'm just gonna give put you in. I know he's a colonel as well, so we're gonna lose a few bits of experience, but I kind of feel like something is bugged, because they're not leveling up anymore. We've been through 2 full missions with an entire squad that hasn't been full, that's not max level yet, and none of them gotten a promotion in that time. So let's make a few items available, and I'll see you in a second, where we're gonna see the complete configuration of this team. So there we go, this is the team we're gonna head out with. I removed the EMP rounds completely, so we have Christoph with his Talon rounds again, and the Mimic Beacon, since he has the most health. And then we have Jazz with a flashbang and the Venom rounds, because they do a bit more damage as well. Then Ulrich is now donning his impressive war suit with a normal rocket launcher, armor-piercing rounds, and an incendiary, well, double incendiary grenade. Then Yang with another warsuit and a blaster launcher, normal vest, and the acid bombs. Then we have Ulrich, not Ulrich, Hugh, with the skulljack and a medkit, because he can do a lot of healing in this mission. And then we have Cedric, who can take a bit of a back position and try to take out any chrysalids that try to get too close. And he has an extra vest, a hazmat suit, that will prevent him from getting poisoned and the like. So this is the team we're gonna head into the Codex Brain Coordinates mission, Operation Bone Mother Wit. So thank you guys enormously for watching. We're gonna have to do that in the next episode. But if you liked the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube using that lovely button down below. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe to the channel using that red button, or the watermark in the bottom right. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye!